Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 24, Environment and Infrastructure. And our topic is Solid Waste Generation. The problem of municipal solid waste management has acquired alarming dimensions in our country, especially over the last decade. Previously, waste management was hardly considered as an issue of concern, as the waste could be easily disposed of in an environmentally safe manner. However, with the time, due to changing lifestyles of people coupled with rapid urbanization and industrialization, the waste has not only increased but have become difficult to be managed. Urban growth, a concomitant of inadequate infrastructure support, is turning India's major cities into waste dumps. The daily per capita generation of MSW, municipal solid waste, in India ranges from about 100 gram in small towns to 500 in large cities. An estimated 48 million tons of municipal solid waste was produced in 1997. For example, the population of Mumbai increased from around 12.3 million in 1991 to 16.3 million in 2001. A growth of about 32.5%, while the municipal waste generation, however, grew from 3,200 tons per day to 5,355 tons per day in the same period, a growth of about 67%. This clearly indicates that growth in municipal waste generation in urban centers has outpaced the growth in population in recent years. The reasons for this trend could be the changing lifestyle, food habits, and changes in standard of living. The per capita waste generation rate has increased from 375 gram per day to 490 gram per day during the 1971 to 1997. This increase, along with the population increase, has tremendously swollen up the figures, total waste generation quantum, adding to the problems of local governments responsible for managing it. Analyzing the data of MSW generated in 35 metro cities between the 1994 to 95 and from 1999 to 2000, there has been a 25% increase in this time period, and Delhi topping the chart with 50% increase. The annual solid waste generated in Indian cities has increased from 6 million tons in 1947 to 48 million tons in 1997. And is expected to increase to 300 million tons per annum by 2047. Urban municipal waste is a mix of paper, plastic, metal, glass, and organic matter. Especially worrying is the increase in non-biodegradable plastic waste. Discarded plastic bags choke drains, prevent smoother grass growth, and exacerbate the damage potential by preventing the biodegradation of waste packed in them. The organic matter has remained almost static at 41% in the past three decades, but the recyclables have increased from 9.56% to 17.18%. Amongst various recyclables, plastics have had a quantum jump from 0.69 to 3.9% more than a 5-fold increase within last 20 years. Disposal is the last stage of the waste management cycle. Pace of industrialization has resulted in increasing amounts of hazardous waste every year. In total, at present, around 7.2 million tons of hazardous waste is generated in the country, of which 1.4 million tons is recyclable, 0.1 million tons is incinerable, and 5.2 million tons is destined for disposal of land. The situation here is also grim in collection and transportation of solid waste. At present, most of the MSW in the country is disposed of unscientifically. This has adverse impact not only on the ecosystem but also on the human environment. About 90% municipal waste is collected by the civic authorities is dumped in low-lying areas outside the city limits, which no provision of lynching. Treatment and landfill gas collection and use are not practiced. Heavy metals find their way to the underground water, rendering it unfit for drinking. The landfill gases too escape into the atmosphere, adding to the greenhouse emissions and resulting in the loss of utilizing the same alternatively. As thermal fuel or for electricity production, the changes in the average waste collection efficiency of the total generation in Indian cities is around 72%, and 70% of Indian cities do not have adequate waste transportation facilities. In Indian cities, MSW generally remains unmanaged due to various factors. For example, inadequate finances, low political priority, inadequately trained personnel, and the lack of proper disposal sites. As a result, residents are prone to disease like hepatitis, malaria, dengue fever, elephantiasis, and cholera, etc. For the waste that is managed, landfilling is the most commonly utilized method of disposal. However, since this primarily translates to open piles of decaying trash rather than controlled underground burial, such unscientific dumping of waste poses a great danger to water sources in the neighboring areas. The problem is further complicated by the frequent presence of other kinds of waste, especially infectious hospital waste, slaughterhouse refuse, and various toxic organic and inorganic material. All these contaminants find their way into local water bodies and subsequently lead to water pollution. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.